Dearly beloved friends and loved ones, we are here assembled in the presence of God to unite Nick Dobbs McDaniels and Bethany Ann Karsten in marriage. The Bible teaches that marriage is to be a permanent relationship of one man and one woman, freely and totally committed to each other as companions for life. Our Lord declared that man shall leave his father and mother and unite with his wife in the building of a home, and the two shall become one flesh. Who gives the bride to be married?
Her mother and I do.
You may be seated. The home is built upon love, which virtue is best portrayed in the 13th chapter of Paul's first letter to the Corinthians. Love is patient and kind. Love is not jealous or boastful. It is not arrogant or rude. Love does not insist on its own way. It isn't resentful. It does not rejoice at wrong, but rejoices in the right. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. So faith, hope, love abide, these three, but the greatest of these is love. Marriage is a companionship which involves mutual commitment of both of you. Responsibility goes along with that, and you will share alike in the responsibilities of life and the joys of life. When companions share a sorrow, the sorrow is halved, and when you share a joy, the joy is doubled. You are exhorted to dedicate your home to your Creator. Take His word, the Bible, for your guide. Give loyal devotion to His church, thus uniting the mutual strength of these two most important institutions. Live in your lives as His willing servants, and true happiness, which is what you are looking for, but that true happiness will be your temporal and eternal reward. Let us pray. Our most gracious and loving Heavenly Father, Lord of life, Lord of love, bestow your grace upon this marriage and seal this commitment with your children, with your love. And you have brought them together by divine providence. So we ask, Lord, that you would sanctify them by your Spirit, that they may give themselves fully one to the other and to you. Give them strength and patience to live their lives in a manner that will mutually bless themselves and honor thy holy name. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, amen and amen.
Amen.
Would you please join right hands? Nick, would you please repeat after me? I, Nick, take thee, Bethany, to be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death us do part.
Till death us do part.
According to God's holy ordinance.
According to God's holy ordinance.
And thereto. I plight thee my troth.
I plight thee my troth.
Bethany, would you please also repeat after me? Nick. I take thee to be my wedded husband.
I take thee to be my wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love.
To love.
Cherish.
Cherish.
And to be faithful.
And to be faithful.
Till death us do part.
Till death us do part.
According to God's holy ordinance.
According to God's holy ordinance.
And thereto I give thee.
And thereto I give thee.
My troth.
My troth.
May I have the rings, please? I only want two.
It's together.
This is one.
Oh, okay.
There you go, buddy.
Okay. Praise the Lord. The wedding ring is a symbol of marriage. It's an outward expression of marriage in at least two ways. The purity of the gold symbolizes the purity of your love for each other. And the unending circle symbolizes the unending vows which you are taking, which may be broken honorably in the sight of God only by death. As a token of your vows, you will give and receive the rings at this time. You get hurt. Nick, if you would repeat after me, you will give the ring and repeat these words. Bethany,
with this ring,
I pledge my life and love to you.
I pledge my life and love to you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit. That's one, right?
Yeah.
Right one. Bethany, you will give the ring and repeat after me. Nick. With this ring. I pledge my love and life to you.
I pledge my love and life to you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
Son.
Son.
And Holy Spirit.
And Holy Spirit.
One size fits all. Now, if you would also join your right hands again and also join your left hands. Now, I want to see your eyes looking into each other's eyes. And in unison, repeat these words. Entreat me not to leave you.
Entreat me not to leave you.
Or return from following you.
Or return from following you.
For you, where you go, I will go.
For where you go, I will go.
And where you lodge, I will lodge.
And where you lodge, I will lodge.
Your people shall be my people.
Your people shall be my people.
And your God, my God.
And your God, my God.
Since they have made these commitments before God and this assembly, by the authority of God and the laws of this state, I declare that Nick and Bethany are husband and wife. Wow. Nick and Bethany, you are no longer two independent persons, but one. What therefore God has joined together, let no man separate. If you would you join us in the prayer that our Lord taught us to pray? Our Father,
who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come,
thy will be done,
on earth
as it is in heaven. Give us this day
our daily bread,
and forgive us our trespasses,
as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us not into temptation,
but deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever. Amen. The Lord bless you and keep you. Praise God. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace.
We do that.
You would. It is time that they bring this commitment together by acknowledging their acceptance of these vows in the bringing together of the sands. You know, many times there are the shifting sands, but here we are bringing them together in one place, in one accord. If you would do that at this time.
You're going to join us? The purple one. We're going to pour it in at the same time, okay? You won. There was no like particular point. Some of my sins though. We come back around this way, buddy.
In closing, I'd like to leave you with these words from Ephesians 5, which says, with God's help and because of his great love for us, let us learn how to invest in one another, to lovingly and sacrificially give of ourselves to each other. This is the key to genuine and everlasting joy. The grace of the Lord be with you. May his Spirit abide in you and with you, and be gracious unto you and bring peace to your life. Amen.
Amen.
Now we can start the procession.
Do I get to kiss her?
Yes. Kiss the bride.
To introduce to you the parents of the bride, Richard and Lorraine Karsten. And the parents of the groom, James and Cammy Voss. Next, we have the ushers, Anthony White and Steve Parson. Up next, we have the junior bridesmaid and junior groomsmen and junior bridesmaid, Haley Brolin. Flower Girl, Aubrey Mershire. Bridesmaids and groomsmen, Logan Fry and Vicky Garland. Thank you.
take of it.
Hello, everyone. I'd like to thank you all for being here this evening, and I'd like to start by congratulating this happy couple, not just on this beautiful ceremony today, but also on this precious bundle of joy they're about to bring into the world. And for those of you who don't know me, I'm Natalie, I'm Bethany's sister, and I know what you're thinking, we must be twins. But actually, Bethany is my much younger baby sister. And when she asked me to be her maid of honor, I couldn't have been more happy. Of course, when I started thinking about this speech, I got quite nervous, but if you've ever tried to tell Bethany no, it's not in the cards.
It's not.
So when I think about my sister, I have to start thinking about those 5 long agonizing years before she was born. When I so wanted a baby sister so bad, I was born to be a big sister. And after what seemed like an eternity of hiding those little round pills my mom took with her vitamins at dinner, and begging, she was finally on her way. And I knew she would be the most beautiful thing I had ever seen, and I had to think of the best name that I could possibly find, and that was Bethany. And then she was born. So I was so happy to finally have her around, but of course I didn't anticipate that she'd be cuter than me with these big blonde curls, that she'd destroy all my Barbies, and that whenever we got in a fight, it would always be my fault because of course I'm older and I should know better. But that was okay with me because she was perfect and I was so happy to have her to play and laugh with. And of course, she's the only person who can truly understand what it's like to be in this crazy family of mine. So now I look at her today, and I'm just so proud of her and the beautiful woman she's become, and how she's picked this guy right here, Nick, that seems to compliment her so well. But you know, I live all the way in Houston, 1,000 miles away, and it's hard for me being the big sister. And when my baby sister gets engaged and ready to get married, you know, we all like Nick, and he seems to be friendly and polite, and he cleans up okay, as you can see, but, you know, I mean, how well can you know him? So, Nick, you're gonna kill me. I hope you're not mad. I have a confession to make. I actually hired someone to follow you. And he's supposed to be here any minute, so... Oh, I see him. There he comes. Okay, here he is. Over here. I had to get the best in the business, someone who could be seen without being seen. So tell me, did you get any dirt on this guy? Any suspicious activity at all?
He's pretty vain, but just don't trust him with matches.
Okay. And how about with your mom? How is he doing with her? Is everything going well?
They seem to be pretty happy together. They laugh a lot, especially when they gain up on me.
Okay, so that sounds good. And how about with you? Is this something I should approve of?
He's pretty nice. He takes me to a lot of fun stuff, cool stuff. Overall, I think he'll make a great
job. Well, that's really all I need to do here. Thanks for all that hard work you put in there.
Don't forget to put this my check in the mail.
Okay. Well, please join me in raising your glass to this beautiful new family and to love and laughter and happily ever after. Cheers.
So for those of you who don't know me, my name is David. I'm the best man, proud to call myself Nick's friend. I'm gonna be that guy who reads from the paper. That's gonna be me. So when Nick first asked me to be his best man, I was honored, of course, but then I realized I'd have to do this and quickly became terrified. So I hope you can bear with me here. So I did what most responsible adult men would do when I found out I had to do the speech and wait until the last minute and then look to YouTube for help. So I wish I could stand up here and give you both marital advice, but I'm not married and I'm not good at relationships, so do the opposite of what you've seen me do so far. So I started asking married couples that I knew for the best advice. And it seemed to be the typical answer was, never go to bed angry, so I insist you guys stay up all night fighting. Then you'll get along forever. All jokes aside though, I couldn't be happy for you both. I know Nick since 8th grade, and I've never seen him so happy, at least sober. So. I do want to say though, both of you look great today, and not just because of the dress and the fancy suits and everything, because you look like you really, really are happy with each other, and that's great to see after all these years. It really is. I lost my place here, you guys clapped and messed me up. It's funny, since he has met you though, he walks around with this silly little smile since you and Caden have come into his life, and it's rather annoying, but I'm glad that it's there because we love having you guys in the family now. So now if you could all just raise your glasses. I drank all mine already, so somebody get on that. But definitely to you guys, may all your ups and downs and ins and outs just be in the sheets and not in the marriage. Thank you.
Hey everybody, thanks for coming out tonight to celebrate Nick and Bethany's wedding. I'm Aunt Kelly, aka Cupid. I met Bethany 2 years ago while working at Bare Minerals, and I thought, oh, she's kind of cute. I think Nick might like this one. So they went on a date, and I got the doggy bag. That was awesome. And of course we got little Nick, my first nephew, my little buddy. He was kind of mad when I got married. Said that he was losing his buddy. You didn't, you gained a buddy. And I gained one today, my little Bethany. We at work say that we like to just pick her up, put in her pocket, take her home because she's so freaking cute. But we're working together again, but today I get to call you my niece. I welcome Caden into our family too, our sweet little Caden, who stole my heart about a year ago calling me Aunt Kelly. Amazing.
That was a year ago?
Yeah, dude, you brought me cupcakes. And Nick, you've always owned my heart, kiddo. I wish you guys the best of luck. You come from a long line of amazing marriages. Follow in our footsteps, you got no problem. Best wishes, raise a glass. Congratulations, Nick and Bethany.
Yes, sir. What? Who's Mike?
That's right, he's Mike. Mike and Nick. I used to know a place, Nick and Mike's. You really like that place.
Wrong wedding.
Just a few words before I pray. I've known the two sisters since they were little girls, and I can tell you some stories. Remember sitting on your mother's shoulders in church, playing in her hair?
She's the tallest she's ever been.
That was a few years ago. But it's something to see. I choked up a little bit this morning when I started the ceremony and looking at this little girl who has grown into Elaine. And then Natalie comes up here and I remember that little girl, and now she's a grown woman and a teacher and got a lot going for her in her life. And then there's Kate. We've known Caden since he was first born, and he started coming to church in a little pumpkin seat. And he's grown, and he and I have had a lot of discussions on dinosaurs and rocks and gems and a little bit of everything, and it's been an enjoyable time.
But now we've come to the time when Nick and Bethany are beginning their new life. And I can think of no better way than to start with a prayer. Heavenly Father, we just thank you this today, Lord, that we have